Hello everyone, I'm Jennifer from the RISM Central Office, and today I'm going to show you how to catalog a score using Muscat. This is the example I'm going to use, and this is available on the RISM website for you to download and print out on your own. So I'll show you how to do that right now. Go to the RISM website, that's www.rism.info, and at the top you'll see the section called Community. Click on Community, and you'll see that logo for Muscat. Click on that. And this is our Muscat page with a lot of information about Muscat. And if you scroll down a bit, you'll see the tutorials right there. And the cards that I've uploaded for the examples are right here. So just click on Score and you'll get to the PDF. While you're here, make sure you've watched my other introductory videos, because in this video right now I'm going to assume that you're familiar with all these basic Muscat functions. Now this is the PDF. Let's go over the example. So you see a card on the left, and this is just a card that I grabbed from our card catalog in my office. It's very basic, but it has all the information you need. On the right, you have the names of all the fields in Muscat. And on the card, you have the composer here, the library Ziglum, the shelf mark, the subject heading, genre, and the title, and so forth. Let's move over to Muscat, and I'll show you how to begin. First, begin a new record for a music manuscript. You go to Create, and then Music Manuscript. As you know, the template is divided into sections, and I like to go through each section one by one. Let's start with the section Library Information and Relations. I'll enter the Ziglum and use the autocomplete to help you. There it is. And enter the shelf mark. Always enter the shelf mark exactly how the library prescribes, so with spaces and periods and dashes and so forth. If you have any information that you can fill out in the other fields, feel free to do so. I don't have any additional information, so I'm just going to leave these fields blank, and then we can move on to the next section, People and Institutions. We do have a composer, so let's enter it here. Again, use the autocomplete to help you. This looks like our person. If you want to double check, or if you're unsure, you can click on the magnifying glass and search the authority file and make sure you found the right person. So when you click on View, this is the authority record for Perez. If you look at his life dates, then we have his profession. And we even link to all the other musical sources by this composer. You can see that this composer fits with their source, so you can be reasonably certain that this is the person we need. Click Select, and we're back to our template. On to the next section, Title and Content Description. In the field Title on Source, transcribe the title exactly. On our card, it's underlined for us, so that's what we'll transcribe. Now we're going to enter the standardized title. If we take a look at our card has given us the title as Io mi sento, but it also says aria as a subject heading. This makes me suspect we might have an opera excerpt. I'm going to do a little more research and I'll try to see if I can find other copies of this aria in the RISM online catalog. So I'll do an advanced search. I have my composer and the title I'm looking for. And if we go through our hits, we can see that this is actually from an opera called Farnace. And if we look at the incipits, they match. And here is our title right there as the incipit text. Going to the next one, it's Farnace again. The incipit is different, but that's okay. We can compare with the next one. Here's the next one. This is our incipit. So as we compare going through the risen records, it looks like we've found the opera that this aria is from, Farnace. Let's go back to Muscat and enter the name of the opera as the standardized title. And we have an excerpt from the opera in C minor. The scoring is for soprano, solo voice, and strings. We can add the subject heading arias here. And let's fill out the full scoring in the field 594. Here you can fill out the language code, Italian. So that's it for this section. Now let's describe the manuscript itself in the section material description. For the source type, we have a manuscript copy. The date or approximate date goes in the field Publishing, Printing, and Production Information, the 260, under Date. Our card tells us that the manuscript is from the end of the 18th century, so we'll enter 1790 to 1799. And this is just RISM's way of describing the end of the century. We also have conventions for other date ranges, and they're all listed in the guidelines, which you can see by clicking on that question mark there. If you scroll down, you'll see that we have different conventions for different time periods. Now for the physical description, we have one score that is 8 folios, and the dimensions are 16 by 22 centimeters. And actually that's it for this section. If you have a digitized copy of the source, you can enter the URL here in this field. But I don't have that, so I'm going to move on to the incipit. And let me switch back to the card for a second. We have two incipits. The first one is for the first violin, and the second one is for the soprano. So first things first, the violin. This is incipit 1-1-1. We have a tempo andante. The instrument is violin 1. And the key is C minor. For the key signature, 3 flats, enter a lowercase b and then B, E, A. The time signature is C. The clef is G2. And the music incipit, it requires plain and easy code, which I will explain in a different tutorial. So for now, let me quickly enter the codes just so that you can see the incipit. There it is. And the next incipit is for the soprano. We still have work number 1 and movement number 1. And the incipit here is 2 because the two incipits sound at the same time. The voice is S. For the text incipit, our card says Fio mi sento mi sento. But for text incipits, we don't include repeated phrases, so we'll stop it at mi sento. But autocomplete suggests Fio mi sento o Dio, so now I'm wondering if the other manuscripts in the RISM OPAC include o Dio. So let's go back to our catalog search. And taking a look at this incipit, it is the same, the music matches, and it does say o Dio. And if you go to the next Incipit, you also see the same thing. Okay, so it looks like the Incipit we have does end in ODEO, and we want to match our Incipit with Incipits already in the catalog, if possible, for the sake of consistency. And I'll just fly through the rest of this Incipit. Good, Incipits are completed. On to the next section. Actually, we don't have anything to add in the section references and notes. So just click save, and we're done. Here is our record. You could stop here, but here's a bonus for advanced Muscat users. You're not required to do the following, but depending on your time and resources, you could enrich your record as follows. I'm back in the edit mode. And you might recall that the title transcription includes the word Argentina 1752. Well, what does this mean? Since our source is from the end of the 18th century, it can't refer to when our manuscript was created. So what happens if I just enter Argentina 1752 into the RISM catalog? Here's my composer. And here I'm back to our opera. So I'm finding other copies of the aria and excerpts from the opera, and the records say that the opera was performed in Rome at the Teatro Argentina in 1752. Of course, it would be a good idea to confirm this with other reference sources besides the RISM catalog. But let's take this information and I'll show you what you can do with it. In the field Note on Performance, enter what we just learned. The opera Farnace was performed at the Teatro Argentina in Rome in 1752. I'll also remind our users that our source dates from later because I don't wish to imply that our manuscript was used at that performance. So now, if we want to be good catalogers, we have to encode this information in our index fields so that the information is standardized and searchable. So what do we have here? Teatro Argentina, Rome, 1752. So, first, Teatro Argentina. That's an institution, so that will go here. Rome goes in its local form, Roma, in the field Location of Performance. And 1752 is a single date that belongs in the Coded Date field. So that's just an example of the depth you can go into in RISM cataloging. Again, it's not required, but our users appreciate this extra information, and you'll get a gold star from us. So now we've cataloged a complete score, and next I'll show you how to catalog a part.